Hi guys, I welcome you all to another video of Software Testing by MKT. So in this video, we are going to talk about prototype model in software development lifecycle. Before I start with this video, make sure that you have watched my software development lifecycle video. Otherwise, you won't understand this. So let's get started. So today, we are going to talk about what do you mean by prototype model in software development lifecycle. I'm going to give you a definition. What do you mean by prototype model? So prototype model is a dummy model. Listen to me very carefully, guys. It is a dummy model prepared by web developer or content developers in which they will convert the text format into image format using a various tools like Adobe Photoshop, Paint or HTML. So now the question arises, why do we go for prototype model? So the reason we go for prototype model is because when customers are new to the market, when customers are new to the business, or when requirements are not clear, and when developers are new to the domain. I'm going to give you one more example. Why do we follow prototype model? Let's take an example. There is a company and there is a customer. This A is a company, this A is a customer, and this B is a company. Now A wants to have a software. They have approached company B for they want to have a software. Now what B company will do? They will send their business analyst to the customer. They will send their business analyst to the customer. Customer will give the requirement. They are new to the business. They will give the requirement, but they will give their 100% requirement. But when it comes to the real scenario, they have not given the 100% requirement. They have only given 75 to 80% of the requirement. Another 20 to 25% of the requirement, this company's BA has assumed. Since they are new to the market, they are not able to give their 100% requirement to the company. So they have given only 80 to 75% of the requirement. Another 20 to 25% of the requirement, this company's BA has assumed. Now what will happen? This BA will go to the company BA, business analyst. He will go to the company and explain the requirement to his technical team. According to whatever the requirement he has understood, in addition of the requirement he has assumed, he will explain to their technical team. Finally, developer will develop the software with the requirements. Test engineers will test that software using the same requirement. And finally, this company will release the software to the company A. Now what company A will do? They will reject the software by stating that software is not meeting customer expectation. Now why it happened? The reason it happened because they were new to the business. They didn't give the proper requirement to the company. And finally, this company assumed few requirements, developed the software and gave it to them. Finally, they rejected the software. So in this case, we go for prototype model. So what we do in prototype model? In prototype model, as I said in the definition, it is a dummy model prepared by our web developer or content developer, wherein they convert text into image. Now what do you mean by this? Whatever the requirement will be there, right? It will be in the text format. Our developers or content developers, they will convert the text format into image using various tools like Paint, HTML, Adobe Photoshop. They will convert it into image format. The reason is, they have the requirement, they will convert into the image, so that customer will actually feel that, oh, their software is going to be look like this at the early stage itself, before the software is developed. If they are going to approve, then we are going to make the real software. If they want to do any modification, we can modify it. I'm going to show you by showing the diagram how the prototype model looks like. So, as I have said in the previous videos, what do you mean by software development lifecycle? If you remember, the first stage of software development lifecycle is requirement collection. Then there comes the feasibility study. After the feasibility study is done, in prototype model, we do design and development of the prototype. In prototype model, after the requirement collection is done and after the feasibility study is done, we do design and development of the prototype. Company will design and develop the prototype. That means what they will do? They are going to convert the text format into image format. What after that they will do? They will do prototype testing. I'm gonna tell you what do you mean by each of this in brief later. After doing prototype testing, they will take customer review. So I'm gonna explain you. This is not that, there is more. I'm gonna explain all these phases. So first, BA will do the requirement collection, then they will do the feasibility study. After that, company will do design and development of the prototype. In design and development of the prototype, they will convert the text format into image format. Who gonna convert it? These web developers will convert the text format to image format. Then there will be the prototype testing. Our test engineers will do. While doing prototype testing, if test engineers are finding any defect, they should communicate with the developers. Developer will fix that defect and give the new prototype model to the test engineers. Test engineers will test it again. If there are no defects, finally they're going to give the prototype model or dummy model to the customer for review purpose. While reviewing the software, if customer wants to do any modification or any changes, or they didn't like the look and feel of an application or anything, they will do the changes by telling it to the company. They will do the modification if they are not happy with the prototype model. What again they will do? They will design and develop the prototype, that is dummy. They're gonna do it again. Then what our test engineers will do? They will do the prototype testing. After that, they're gonna give the software again. Dummy model software again to the customer review. If customer is agree here that yeah, this is how we want the software. Finally, what company will do? They will do the actual design process. Design. You remember SDLC model? The first step is requirement collection, feasibility study. What is the third? Design. This three we have added because it's a prototype model. After design, what is that? Coding. After coding, what is that? Installation. And after that, maintenance. So after customer review is done and they have agreed that this is how they want the software, then actual design will start. In this, who will do the design? Architect will do the design. If you have seen my SDLC video, you gonna understand each one of this in detail. The developers will do coding, test engineers will do. After coding, there is testing. Oh, I missed it. After coding, there is actual testing. That means they will test the software whether it is working perfectly or not. If test engineers have verified that, yeah, it is working perfectly fine, then what test engineers will do? Then what company will do? Finally, they will release the software to the customer. Our IT engineer, field engineer, they will go to the customer place and they will install the software. and after that maintenance phase starts, in which there is an agreement between the two company that over a period of 6 months or 1 year, that if you are facing any defect or if you want to do any modification in between the service level agreement period, we gonna change it. This is what the maintenance phase tell. So this is how my prototype model looks like. Hope it is very clear, guys. So I'm going to tell you guys what are the disadvantages of choosing a prototype model. So the first disadvantage of choosing a prototype model is it is a time consuming job. Total investment will be more. These are the main two disadvantages of choosing prototype model in software development lifecycle. Now the question arises, what are the advantages of prototype model? So the prototype model advantages is we can set the high level, we can set the high expectation for the customer. How? As we know that we gonna convert the text format into image format, we can set the high customer expectation. This is the my first point. Second advantage is customer will get to see the software at the early stage itself. Because we are going to give them the prototype model or dummy model, customer will be knowing how their software will be, it will look in future. And what is the third? The third advantage of prototype model is requirement changes are allowed. Just because we are doing the prototype model, dummy model, and we are taking the customer review, like did you like it or not, chance we accept the requirement because it will be a dummy model. Requirement changes are allowed. So these are the biggest advantages of prototype model. If you have any doubt, let me know. If you have any concern, comment it out. I will give you the answer. And subscribe to my channel, like to this video. And guys, if you want me to prepare any further video, please let me know in the comment section. I will be preparing that. And I added my blog and Quora in the link description profile. Please check it out. Thank you.